Welcome in, ladies and gentlemen, to TCAL Semifinals from St. Mary's College High School here at Thomas M. Brady Park as the Panthers take on the Gauchos in a baseball playoff of great importance. The winner of this goes on to Friday to the TCAL Finals, probably against Pinole Valley. St. Mary's has a home record of 14-5 and came back to beat the Salesian Pride in their previous game, while the Gauchos beat Kennedy 14-1 and then St. Joe's 11-4 in their two rounds of playoffs. We're just about set for first pitch as Kevin Flemmer will be on the hill, and we will be right back with live action. Back inside the broadcast booth in our pregame, my partner Andre Sims has got the lineups for you. What do we got today, Andre?
So for El Cerrito, we have Pickett leading off. He will be playing left field. Batting second will be Wing at short. Vanekhart will be in center field. Number four, Rutledge, will be playing third and batting cleanup. Delaney, the pitcher, will be fifth. Bernal, a good friend of mine, Aiden Bernal, actually, will be DHing today. Locker Bravo, number 28, will be in right field, batting sixth. Seventh will be Shebeck at first. Ninth, will be Harrison at second. And rounding up, not batting today, but playing catcher, is number 13, Flores.
As for our Panthers.
Panthers, we have Arlo Rudy leading off and batting second, followed by Nico Aldaco, the shortstop, a couple sophomores on top of the lineup. The big man, Devin Mahoney, batting third. Kevin Flemmer, our pitcher for today, will be in the cleanup spot. Max Goldstein will be out in left. Nick Ulch playing first. Peter Scheinman, the DH. Steven Giantino will be catching. Josh Cohn will be batting third. And Jimmy Smail in center will not be batting.
And the two pitchers on the mound today will be Kevin Flemmer and Ryan Delaney. But first to Flemmer, who he had quite the season, going 8-1 in his senior campaign with an ERA of 1.14, and it better be a league high, 81 strikeouts.
Wow.
As for Delaney, that senior goes 6'2", 175. We do not have his stats. We couldn't get those off of Max Prep, so do not have those for you. Just have his stature. But here is how the Panthers will line up defensively, as Andre just said. Outfield, Goldstein at left, Smail center, Mahoney in right, Cohen at third, and Aldaco at short, left side of the infield. Right side, we're going Arlo and Nick behind the plate, Steven Giantini, Kevin Flemmer pitching, and of course, Peter Scheinman, the designated hitter.
To a quote to Wayne Harper, Steven Giantini in the squat.
In the squat, yeah, the Kruko. So we will be right back. We're just about ready to go. We will be right back for the first pitch. So we're all set. Kevin Flemmer taking the hill. And as Andre said, it'll be Pickett, Wing, and Van Eckert, the 1-2-3 hitters to face him. By name, Adarius Pickett, Alexander Wing, and Perry Van Eckert, to be specific. The two juniors and the senior. Well, we're going to have a good one today, and the winner of this will go on and play Pinole Valley. And it's an interesting matchup because Pinole Valley is a team that has beaten St. Mary's twice. Their only two league losses. Meanwhile, El Cerrito has beat Pinole Valley twice. So even though St. Mary's has lost to Pinole Valley, St. Mary's has beaten EC twice. It's an interesting go-around. They beat them 5-1 and 1-0. Both pretty close games. So we're expecting for a good one today. Maybe a far cry runs-wise from Friday's 12-4 win over Salesian. But we are ready for some baseball.
Yes, runs are not something you expect to see much when Kevin Plummer's on the mound. Like you said, that 1.1, I think you said 1.4 ERA?
1.14.
That is pretty low for any pitcher at any level.
So Pickett will step in.
And for those of you social media buffs out there, got some Twitter names for you.
Make sure to follow us on Twitter as we will bring you live updates in-game and also other Panthers. We're ready for our first pitch of this ballgame. Flemmer to Pickett. Winds, fires, and it is a curveball just a little bit low, and we are underway from bright, sunny Brady Park.
Yeah, it is a beautiful day for baseball.
Here's Flemmer's 1-0, and that is on the corner for strike one. Kevin Flemmer, soon to be Oregon State Beaver. Kevin Flemmer signed on with the baseball program there. Wish him best of luck in his future baseball games. That one's by Steven. Go to 2-1. Shout out to all of you watching out there. Special shout out to Mae Petty, who will be watching on her computer at home. So big thanks to all of our Panthers followers. The 2-1 is grounded foul down the third baseline.
The Panthers defensively are shading Pickett to go oppo here, actually. This is a large gap in left center field as Jimmy Smale is shifted significantly over to the right field gap.
That's good on a two-strike count because you're just trying to foul a pitch away on Flemmer as this one is swung on and missed. That drops at Steven, but he will throw on to first and complete the strikeout. So Kevin gets his first strikeout of the ballgame. And that's how this game is underway. Here's Wing. First pitch, Steve Reich on the outside corner. Good looking fastball that time. That fastball stays low. We'll go 1-1. First inning of 7, barring any extra innings, but a little crazy around here last couple times. Here's the 1-1 to Wing, and that one's also outside, 2-1. Swing in front of Flemmer. Here's the 2-1, and that is hit to center. Going back is Jimmy Smale, and he will make the belt-high catch. So Jimmy Smale, who is playing in this game today for Malik Eddy, gets a little action in the first, and now two are away.
It's about as easy as a catch a center fielder can make. Jimmy Smale with a quick little show him some love for Jimmy Smale in the other going. Hooked it up with the peace sign.
Here's Perry Van Eckert, and his first pitch is swung on and missed. Big looping swing that time, trying to go down that right field line towards that miniature scoreboard. Big Ocho on the hill. His 0-1 to Perry Van Eckert is swung on and missed. Similar pitch, similar swing, and now it's 0-2. Flemmer, ahead 0-2. Here it is, and it is just a little bit high.
That's a good waste pitch, 0-2. You don't want to give it away. Hopefully the fish was biting, but not there.
He's got a couple more chances. The 1-2 is swung on, popped into the screen. So Perry stays alive. So Flemmer looking for that strikeout pitch. He's already got one. Winds, fires, swung on and missed. Flemmer with two strikeouts. No runs, no hits, no errors. We will move on to the bottom of the first. Nothing, nothing. Back inside, live, bottom of the first. Tyler Petersen, Andre Sims, Sylvia Wedderburn, Tazio Otis, and Kirsten Wong. Arlo Rudy will lead it off against Ryan Delaney. Delaney is senior and supposedly their best pitcher. His first pitch of this game is high. The 1-0 is a little bit outside. Not good enough for the umpires lacking. That's 2-0.
Arlo is your prototypical leadoff hitter. Good contact, good speed, and really knows what to, can use the whole field.
And that one's high, 3-0. And maybe it's just me, Andre, but when a player's got those high socks, he just looks faster.
Oh, yeah.
Arlo's sporting the knee highs today. The 3-0 pitch is low, ball four. A four-pitch walk to begin this ball game, and a very ominous start for Mr. Delaney. That'll bring up Nico Aldaco. Nico has got some power. He's hit a couple home runs this year, four to be exact. First pitch is in the dirt. It squirts away from the catcher, Flores, but not far away where Arlo could advance. And now Delaney has thrown five straight balls.
Kyle, you mentioned that power that Nico does possess. Even as a freshman last year on varsity, also hit about four or five home runs. So it's definitely there.
Here's the 1-0. And that one is on the inside corner, and Delaney's got his first strike. So maybe you want to start things out, shake it up a little. You got a 1-1 count. Maybe you want to put on a play here.
You got good speed on first, good contact at the plate. I don't see why not. It's a good way to test a catcher's arm in the early going.
And now Delaney will check on Arlo.
Perhaps the Elsewhere coaching staff has the same thought we did, Tyler.
Nico waves about a couple times. Now Delaney comes set, stands on the mound. The pitch to Nico is low, 2-1. It's not the ideal start from any pitching coach's perspective for Delaney. Walked the first hitter, 2-1 to the second place hitter. Comes set on the mound. Fires to the plate, and Nico will foul this one off the screen. Two and two. Nico taking a long look down at Coach Nelson, who's down the third base coach. Middle infield playing double play depth. Outfield normal. Arlo with two steps off a second. Here's the 2-2 from Delaney. It's on its way, and this is popped into shallow right field. Going over is the right fielder, and he will make the catch going into foul territory. So Nico will pop out, and I'll be the first out of this inning. And now here come the big boys. Here's Devin Mahoney.
The big boys are right.
Devin picked up a couple RBIs in the previous playoff game. In the regular season, he batted a cool .492 with four bombs and 21 RBIs.
Those of you that don't know baseball, .492 is very, very good.
Very good.
So, to put it in perspective, he's getting a hit once every two times he's up at the plate. So, we'll take that. We'll definitely take that.
And the first pitch to Devin is just off the plate, 0-1-0. Delaney waiting on the mound, still waiting. Now we'll throw over to first, and pickoff attempt is not even close as Arlo scampers back to the back.
Delaney seems to be very concerned with Arlo on first base. You got to wonder if that's going to affect his concentration to the hitter and maybe leave one up for Devin.
And that one's also outside. 2-0. So with three hitters, he's thrown about seven balls and two strikes.
Not the kind of control you want early in a ball game.
In a playoff ball game, make it. Now the outfield is playing almost close to the wall, no doubles-esque. That is the 2-0 becomes 3-0. And now Delaney's really in trouble of walking Devin. And you know he will have the green light, 3-0.
Yes, he will.
Delaney comes set. Waits on the mound. Now throws. Devin slaps this down foul. And that will go down by the auditorium. So Devin had a good hack on a high fastball.
The thing about Devin that makes him so great is like his swing looks so effortless. He doesn't look like he's trying. It's just smooth through the zone and then pow.
I'm not even sure if he's wearing batting gloves today. There's the 3-1, and that is fouled straight back. It's on that fastball. Now it's 3-2. So Delaney's come right after him here, and definitely up for the challenge is Devin. So we have 3-2 count with Arlo on first. He walked. Delaney peers in, gets his sign from Flores, now comes set. Payoff pitch to Devin. Arlo's on the move, and that is just outside ball four. An extremely close pitch, maybe a little too close to take on a two-strike count. But the Pandas will have two base runners on two walks, and here comes Kevin Flemmer. And now we're going to have a full staff meeting here as he brings the infield in, does the pitching coach. So he'll talk it over with Delaney. So their conversation finishes up, and up comes Flemmer.
Kevin Flemmer on the year, batting 309. Kevin Flemmer on the year, had a nice 309 clip.
He hit a home run. We brought to you that one in the previous game. This one's fouled back. So two men on. Pretty good spot for the Panthers to be in the first inning. Sets up outside. The 0-1 is on the corner, strike two. It's a pretty good looking pitch that time from Delaney.
Tyler, you notice Arlo is not exactly being held on here. So you wonder if he gets a big secondary lead and a base hit up the middle or anywhere to the outfield. He could probably score on a single.
They're also playing Kevin fairly deep. Here's the 0-2. That is in the dirt. 1-2. Left fielder is pinched toward the left center gap, so they're giving Kevin the foul line if he pulls one. And this one goes to opposite field, and it'll hang up just enough. They'll throw it at first to try to double up Devin, and that gets over the first baseman's head. So Flemmer hits a line drive to right field. So the runners will not advance. Two outs.
Both runners also almost doubled up as both Devin and Arlo both got a little bit too far off the bag for comfort.
So maybe a more accurate throw that time would have gotten Devin off at first, who's not, doesn't possess the greatest speed. And here's Max, who homered in his previous game against Salesian, the game we brought to you last Friday. Here's the first pitch to Max, is high.
Max Goldstein with that homer has now an average of 333, one home run, and now 9 RBIs on the year.
These numbers do not include the stats from our previous game. The 0-1 is on its way, and that is a strike. Took the umpire a minute. 1-1. So Arlo on second, he walked. Devin on first, he walked as well. And two fly balls to the right fielder, that's where we're at. And it's 1-1 to Max. Delaney on his way, and if that's outside, 2-1. And Delaney started every hitter except Flemmer with the ball. Those aren't the kind of signs you like early.
And even if he were to escape this inning with no runs, you got to think about pitch count for one and just confidence if you're throwing this many balls to hitters in the early going.
Max in a good hitter's count, 2-1. Pitch is on its way, and that is a strike at the knees. Max didn't necessarily like that call too much either. 2-2 with two outs. Deuce is wild. Two men on. Here's Delaney's pitch. And is swung on and missed. Off speed, went low, and the Panthers are retired. So no runs, no hits, no errors. Two walks for the Panthers. We will go to the top of the second. No score. Top of the second, it'll be the 4-5-6 hitters to face Flemmer. First up, Jamal Rutledge, third baseman today. First pitch from Flemmer. It's on its way, a little bit high. Right back with a 1-0 is at the knees. Umpire, just a quick observation with the first two innings. Seems to like the pitch of the knees a little bit more than the pitch of the letters. That 1-1 is popped into the screen. So we'll go 1-2.
Flemmer pitching very methodical here in the early going. Two early strikeouts and really attacking these hitters always on. The attack always in pitcher's counts as opposed to Delaney Frosarito, who is constantly having to work from behind in the count.
He's got a 1-2 count here again, and that one's high. Flemmer struck out two in the opening frame. He's got a two-strike count on the cleanup hitter, Rutledge. Gets his sign from Steven on the mound. Now winds, fires, and that one is swung on and missed, went up and in with a fastball, and Rutledge strikes out. So four hitters and three strikeouts are for Kevin Flemmer. And this will bring up the pitcher, Delaney. Delaney batting fifth, so double threat as a good curveball breaks in there. Now a fastball called strike two. So Flemmer not messing around at all. It's another two-strike count. Delaney's got to fight back. Here it is from Flemmer. That's a fastball way outside. Maybe a little overthrown. Maybe hung on to it just a little bit long. But the waste pitch serves its purpose. Here's the 1-2 from Flemmer, and that one is a curveball fouled back. Yeah. Here's the 1-2 once more. That's a fastball. Strike three called right on the outside corner. And Flemmer's got it going through the first five hitters. Four strikeouts. His first backwards K.
For those of you interested in the pro circuit, the Giants have taken a 1-0 lead in the early going against the Blue Jays.
I believe the A's were losing earlier, is that right?
The A's have lost. It was 6-2 the final.
And a first pitch strike to Bernal. May see Kevin on one of those teams someday. And how about a second pitch for a strike? So there's the morning, afternoon. Just need one more.
Good night.
The 0-2 from Flemmer.
Got him.
Oh! Now, I've seen some close pitches in my life, but that had to be the closest pitch I've ever seen right there.
You got to wonder, where did that miss? And like we point out in the softball game, you don't necessarily have the best angle.
Oh, and that comes right back with another one. Okay, yes, we do not have the best angle, but those are two juicy pitches that Bernal just takes. How about the 2-2? Curveball swung on a miss, so Flemmer does get the strikeout. Five strikeouts and six batters. Took a little bit longer than he would have liked, but we will go on to the bottom of the second. Panthers get another shot at Delaney. No score. It'll be the sophomore, Nick Ulch, to lead things off here in the bottom of the second. And the first pitch, Delaney, is outside. So, not the closest pitch there.
Like you said, with the exception of Kevin Flemmer, every batter thus far for Delaney has been started off with a ball.
He wears the number 31 in black and green. And his 1-0, it's on his way. Swung on a missed, off speed. Got Nick to swing over it. We'll go 1-1. One and two now as Nick swings over that one and misses it badly. Playing first base today. Very versatile fielder. Plays the outfield and first base. The 1-2 is outside. We'll go 2-2. Delaney just waits on that mound, and Nick just calls time. So here comes the 2-2. Swing and a miss. Nick overpowered, to say the least, on that time. So Delaney gets him to start out this inning. Second strikeout for Ryan Delaney. And here's Peter Scheiman. He's batting for Jimmy Smale, center fielder. Kevin Flemmer obviously pitching and hitting. First pitch Peter sees is a strike at the knees.
And Tyler, I got to say, the high knee socks are one thing, but when you're rocking the stirrups.
That's old-fashioned there. So,
oh, yeah.
Big props to Peter rocking the stirrups today. And that one is on the outside corner. Takes a dislike of that pitch. And we'll go 0-2.
It kind of begs the question, if that was a strike, Tyler, then where did those two pitches from Flemmer miss?
That's an excellent point. Here's the 0-2 pitch to Scheinman. And that one is rocking into right field off of the screen. So that'll be a foul ball. So it'll stay 0-2. Infield back. Waiting for the ground ball. Outfield playing more of a shallow outfield. And the 0-2 is not on its way. We have time once again. Delaney not exactly the quickest worker. But we'll have the 0-2. That one is chopped towards third baseman. Rutledge on to first. And the foot was off the bag of the first baseman. Shabick. Rutledge had to charge for that ball. And he threw it wide, and Shabick could not keep his foot on the bag. So Peter will be aboard on the error on the third baseman, Rutledge. So the Panthers, fortunate that time, they get a one-out runner. And now here's Steven Giantini. So Peter on first. Delaney will have to go back into the stretch. Here's the first pitch to Steven, and that's low. Again, these teams have met twice, once here at Brady Park, once at Cerrito Vista. Both times were St. Mary's wins, 5-1 and 1-0 respectively. Goes behind him, and Peter will take second.
Yeah, I know. Tyler, you got to wonder about his control right now. Not often do you see pitches thrown behind batters.
I mean, there are wild pitches, and there are wild pitches. So Steven in the driver's seat, 2-0, I believe, might be 1-1, but we don't always get the best stuff since we're kind of far out here, so we're going to go 2-0 for now. Swing and a miss. Took a good hack of that one. Got a fastball right down the heart of the plate. And we'll go 2-1. It is 2-1. So Peter on second. One out. 2-1 to Giantini. Peter dancing off second. Pitch to Steven is a strike, a little bit low.
And a little bit outside, too. But who am I to judge, Tyler? I'm not the home plate umpire.
So he does like the low pitch, not so much the high one. So he prefers the knees or the ankles to the letters. So 2-2 now to Steven. RBI opportunity for the junior catcher. Here it is on its way, swung on and missed. A long swing by Steven that time, and there are two outs. Delaney picks up his third strikeout, and here's the third baseman, Josh Cohen. Cohen hasn't exactly had the greatest season at the plate, but He is a contact hitter, and he will go to all fields, which is what you want in a two-out RBI situation. First pitch is on the outside corner. Peter on second on the error, then we've got on the wild pitch. The Panthers still don't have their first hit. That one is hit towards second. On two hops, second baseman and the first baseman. The inning is over. Nothing comes of the error. Panthers do not score. They will go on to the top of the third. Mr. Andre Sims will take over play-by-play, and I will do my color duties, so we'll be right back.
Welcome back in, everybody. We have a top third here from Brady Park. Leading off, we have a Lochner Bravo out in right. First pitch from Plummer is hit on the ground to Nico at short, and he will throw over to Nick Ulch for the first out. For those of you scoring at home, that's a 6-3. So, contrary to the El Cerrito pitcher, Kevin's been making quick work all game as a one-pitch out to begin the third. And it's a first pitch strike to the first baseman, Shebeck. The 0-1 Flummers swung on and missed. It's a 0-2 is a good curveball there down in the zone.
And the other thing that, which is keeping Kevin's pace is he is very much got a very good rhythm out there, going very quickly.
And that is a chopped off of the facade.
The facade.
Words of the great coach Vinny. So, count stays at 0-2 here on Shebeck. Pitch fouled back again. So Shebeck putting up a little bit of a battle here.
He's down 0-2, got to swing at anything close. Put himself in that hole, swinging through a couple. Good fastball and curveball from Flemmer. Now he's just fighting off these fastballs.
Curveball is chopped in front of home plate, fielded by Flemmer. He will throw on Nick Ulch for the out. And to your point about swinging anything close, I think if he hadn't already, he has earned a reputation as a strike thrower in this game. He's been around the plate the entire game thus far, so you've got to wonder, you're not going to get very many pitches out of the zone. And we got Harrison, the second baseman, up, rounding out the bottom of the order. First pitch is a strike.
Right at the knees. Great location to start off a hitter.
Second pitch, once again, another strike.
And you can tell he's overmatched there. He was either way late or way out in front of that fastball. Probably way late.
Yeah, I'm betting on way late. That ball's popped up in the infield. Eckholtz called it. He will put it away for out number three. So no strikeouts this inning, but Plummer once again makes quick work of the Gaucho lineup as they've set down all nine first time around. And we will be right back for the bottom of the third. Welcome back in. Bottom of the third. We got top of the order here. Arlo Rudy will step in again. Walked to lead off the first inning. First pitch is a fouled back. And the count will go 0-1.
So second time through this lineup, they all got to see what Delaney's got. So got a better chance this time. Arlo, of course, saw four wide ones, so he's really getting to see the strike zone for the first time.
Second pitch from Delaney's inside to Rudy. And the Panthers had their fair share of base runners first time through the order between a few scattered walks, but did not manage to put anything on the board as that pitch was well inside to the backstop. So the count is at 2-1 here. Pitch once again is outside, so 3-1 to Arlo.
He's in danger of walking him once again.
Pitch is swung on, hit on the ground to the first baseman, and he will take it. Oh no, he will toss it off to the pitcher Delaney, and Arlo is out. So one down here for the Panthers as a Nico Aldaco, the shortstop, will step in. Nico flew out, shallow fly ball to right field his last time up. First pitch is a strike, off speed pitch, looked like a bit of like a
had a little sliding action.
A little bit
it.
Of like a slurve. Not quite a slider, but not quite the 12-6 of curveball. That is on the ground to the shortstop, and the throw is low, but scooped nicely by the first baseman.
He got that same pitch again and didn't want to take it. Had a good, pretty good hack at it, just got on top of it.
So one shortstop grounds out to the other. And we'll have Devin Mahoney. First pitch from Delaney.
Devin himself is a rally even with two outs.
Is a low to Mahoney, so 1-0.
He's dangerous in all situations.
Every situation. always a threat to go deep and can go deep to all fields, too. As someone right there hits a deep fly ball to left field, and that was diving attempt by the left fielder, and he drops it. Then we'll round the corner and stop at second with a double.
I'm not sure how to score that one. The left fielder seemed to have a pretty good beat on it. Didn't seem like an all-challenging fly ball. He went to a semi-dive, and I think it just went off of his glove.
That was the left fielder Pickett there who had it hit off his glove. And you know, I think you're right. I'm not quite sure how to score that.
I'll give him the hit. Not exactly a routine play, but...
So, as it stands in our book, that is the first hit for the Panthers. A double to left field for Devin Mahoney. Now we have Kevin Flemmer up.
So we're giving Devin the double. And there it is, the one-man rally. He, look at him, he's in scoring position already.
Time is called. Catcher will take a chat with Delaney real quick.
Got to revisit that last bat for Flemmer. Realize what he threw to you. Got ahead of you quickly, so maybe you're swinging earlier in the count.
I think Flemmer's been intentionally walked.
So they will intentionally walk Flemmer. They're not even going to go after him.
Set up the force play opportunity.
So here's Max Goldstein.
Max Goldstein, yes.
They didn't go through the formalities of throwing four wide ones, so just send him on his way.
And I feel like it's really the lesser of two evils there, Tyler, because Kevin Flemmer is batting at 309 and Max Goldstein at 333, so it's pick your poison. Both of them with the home run power, as they've shown. So
the Panthers will have two men on.
So two men on, two men out. And Max Goldstein, the left fielder, will stand in. RBI opportunity, looking to get that first run on the board. Delaney steps off, steps back on. Delaney gets the sign, comes set. His first pitch is a strike. So 0-1 to Goldstein here.
Pretty good looking pitch. He kind of was saying hit me, but Max may be told to take the first strike in a pretty good spot.
Ball's hit on the ground weakly to the right side, and it is booted by the second baseman. And they throw it home to nobody. And Devin Mahoney's on the board, so I don't know whether that's one or two errors on the second baseman there. The first one for booting the ground ball, and the second one for seemingly throwing to no one at home plate.
It's a terrible error. You have all the time in the world. You boot the ball, and then the catcher does not cover home plate, and the Panthers have their first run.
Although I don't think necessarily the catcher's fault. The catcher was running to first base to play backup as normally instructed to. So it was the second baseman's fault for not realizing the fact that there was no catcher at home plate.
Absolutely.
And just shucking the ball.
So just the one error. Or if you really want to say error advancing for Max to second, well, here's Nick Ulch. And he swings and misses.
So after swing, Nick Ulch trying to clear the bases. Lefty with some power. Maybe eyeing the Death Valley, that is the right center field gap here at Brady Park.
So Mahoney scores, and Max will get on the E4. Second error.
Pitch is fouled back by Nick Ulch. So 1-2 count here. The pitch from Delaney swung on and missed by Nick Ulch. So that is Nick's second K of the day. And the Panthers draw first blood here. It will be 1-0 going to top of the fourth, and we will be right back. Welcome back in. Top of the fourth here from Brady Park, and Kevin Flemmer will deal to the top of the order. That is Pickett, the left fielder. Pickett struck out his first time around as he fouls the first pitch back for 0-1.
So ultimately, after all the confusion and chaos that was that bottom of the third, there'll be two errors on the second baseman. Harrison. One for the ball in the first place. And the second on the throw, which Max advanced. Second pitch.
Pitch from Flemmer is on its way and swung on and missed. 0-2.
Remember, that all started when Devin hit that fly ball to left at the left fielder for that handle. It doubled as he got past the diving glove. There's that one-man rally we talked about.
The waist pitch is high. 1-2.
With a gift run. We'll take him anyway. Yeah.
And with the way Flemmer's throwing so far, one run might be all you need for today. That ball's hit on the ground. Fielded by Arlo. The throw will be late. So a great effort by Arlo showing the range to get to that ball. But in the end, it was just hit too far up the middle.
And 2-9, you might get him a leadoff hitter. Definitely doesn't pause too much speed, so he's good.
So the first base runner here for the Gauchos, and that will bring up Wing, the shortstop.
The three first innings for Flemmer. Did you hear anything I said?
Time is called as Flemmer steps back on the mound, get ready to deliver the first pitch. On its way, and it would be low.
So any thoughts of a no-hitter or a perfect game go out the window, so both teams each have a hit. But,
I'll still take a one-hit shutout. Pick off play. Pick it back easily, as he didn't have that big of a lead. Another pickoff play. Throw from GTNE, and they got
it. It is a perfect throw.
That was a strike.
Stevens showing off the arm.
Not only was it a strong throw, but it was accurate. It was right on the money. All Arlo had to do was catch it and apply the tag. Beautiful throw.
On the money for the first-year catcher. Chantini comes up big.
So that leadoff single is erased as Pickett gets caught stealing. And that is a ball to wing. I do believe we have a 2-2 count now. Pitch from Flemmer. It's a strike.
Maybe now a 2-2 count.
Now a 2-2 count.
You can go right after him now. No base runner. Be aggressive.
So Flemmer in the stretch for all of about three pitches. And maybe now a 2-2 count.
Maybe now a 2-2 count. So, again, not we do not have the greatest... We're pretty far away from the action, so... intricacies such as umpire raising his arm, sometimes we can get lost in translation from the view here.
Check swing foul.
So definitely two strikes.
Yes, they're definitely two strikes. We've established that. Pitch from Flemmer on its way. Line drive shot. Nico dives, can't make the catch, throw over to first, not in time. So good effort from Aldaco. It's short, and I don't know. I'm feeling about something in the air because the shortstops seem to love hitting into each other today, Tyler.
Yeah, and I wouldn't necessarily say it's an error. It was a line drive, but I'm going to give the hit. So
it was definitely a do-or-die play for Nico. Sinking line drive, hit right at him. Not much you can do.
No. So back-to-back singles.
Soft pickoff throw over to first. Just keeping an eye on. Pitch from Flemmer on its way, and it is fouled into the screen. Pickoff play.
Ben Eckert in his first at bat, he struck out on some dismal looking swings, so Flemmer should try to go after the hitter here. He is a third place hitter, so he's definitely got maybe the best hitter on this team, as the third place hitter sometimes is.
Pitches outside from Flemmer.
But a big special thank you to Tazi Otis and Kirsten Wong for hitting us up with some grub.
Pitcher Flemmer on its way, and it is also high.
2-1 count then.
Flemmer comes set. Pitch on its way. Once again high, and that'll be a walk. So El Cerrito now with two runners on. So, two runners on here for El Cerrito, one down here in the inning. Defensively, Nico shading the runner second, making sure he stays close. First pitch is swung on and missed, but the ball gets away from Steven, and the runners will advance. And that's big because not only do they put both runners in scoring position, Tyler, but it also gets rid of the double play opportunity.
And now a fly ball will tie it with only one out. Luckily, Rutledge swung and missed, but Steve quite couldn't handle that curveball as it went in the dirt. So Rutledge has a chance to redeem himself. He had an error earlier in this game. So it'll be second and third with only one gone.
Flipper comes set, and the first pitch to Rutledge is on its way. And it is a strike. Excuse me, second pitch. So we have an 0-2 count here. Flipper looking to get the big second out. Pitch on its way. And strike three calls on the outside corner. So good pitch from Flemmer there to get the big second out of the inning. So that takes away the sac fly opportunity.
That's a big boy pitch right there, right on the outside corner. Perfectly positioned. And he gets that second out.
So two outs now. Runner still on second and third for El Cerrito. And we have Delaney, the pitcher, up. Looking to help his own cause here.
Fouled back to the screen with two outs. It'll be just, they only need a single here, so Flemmer's still got to be careful.
Single here could potentially score two for El Cerrito, so definitely don't want to challenge and just leave one out over the middle of the plate. As Delaney is the fifth place hitter. Great pitch there, the big curveball from Flemmer for the strike.
Now he's need one more to get out of this jam.
Flemmer looking to escape this jam unscathed. And that is called strike three. Delaney does not like that call at all. Rips his batting gloves off in disgust. And we will take a quick break and come back for bottom of the fourth.
Welcome back.
We got bottom four here. Panthers leading 1-0. And leading off for the Panthers, we have Peter Scheinman. First pitch from Delaney. It's down low. And Tyler, you got to wonder, as Delaney was clearly frustrated after that last strikeout, you got to wonder if his... he's a little frustrated in his mind right now, and you got to think this might play a role in his pitching right now.
Well, when they tell you, like a hitter, if you strike out, don't take it into the field. But Delaney, as he's shown not that great control this game, seems to be taking it into the field.
Bye, guys.
The ball's fouled off by Scheinman. So we have a 1-1 count here. Scheinman digs back in here. Pitch from Delaney on its way. And it is a called strike on the outside corner.
Peter going to want to swing the bat on those pitches. Plummer got two Ks on that same location.
That ball is a hit high, deep to right, and it will be off of the net. Foul. So Peter definitely showing the ability to go to the opposite field, as the Gauchos are shading him to go the opposite way.
Definitely giving him the left field line. And maybe Van Eckert in center, maybe a couple steps toward the right field side of second base.
High pitch is fouled straight back off the screen. I'm honestly not sure what the count is right now, but
I believe it is 1-2.
1-2, there you go. Pitch on its way. Ground ball right back up to middle for a base hit. So a leadoff single here for the Panthers as Peter Scheinman sends one right back where it came from.
Good hit. You're down in the count. Just kind of lunge at it. Make contact and hope it finds a hole. That one had eyes, fortunately. So Peter, with his first hit of this day, he's been on base twice. I'll bring up Steven Giantini.
Catcher putting on some defensive signs for El Cerrito. And like Tyler said, Giantini now steps in. Giantini struck out last time around. Looking to move Peter Scheinman right along as attempt to pick off throw is late. Blaney comes set out of the stretch. And another pickoff throw. It was close. Peter might have been leaning there, but either way, back in safe. Giantini shows button. That's a good one down the first base line, and Blaney will toss it over to the first baseman and get the out, so score that one as a sacrifice for Giantini.
He gets the job done. He'll go back, get high fives as he goes in, so there'll be a runner on second with only one out. It'll be Cohen and Rudy. Josh and Arlo. With two shots to drive in Scheinman to try to double this lead.
And Josh Cohen steps into the box. A quick side note, that 1-0 lead I talked about for the Giants is quickly gone as they scored 5 unearned off Vogelsong in the bottom of the first. And that first pitch was a ball. I lied. Out of 6 minutes to go, 8-1 Blue Jays. That's J.P. Arencibia, 2-run home run. That pitch is low from Delaney. 2-0, the count now.
So Zito gives up 6 in the first yesterday, and Vogelsong off to that great of a start here.
5 unearned. Time is called here. Count remains 2-0 on Josh Cohen. Number 9 hitter, and we will send it back to Arlo Rudy at the top. Peter Scheinman dancing on second, and the pickoff throw gets away. Scheinman a little late getting up, so no advance there.
Yeah, definitely alert Peter was, but the center fielder, Perry Van Eckert, very, very alert as soon as that ball got away to get on it. A very heads-up play that did not allow Peter to advance to third. They'll still stay 2-0 to Josh. Or take it back.
Pitch from Delaney, and it is strike on the outside. I thought it was a little bit outside, but it is a 2-1 count now to Josh Cohen. And that is a base hit into right field, and Peter Scheinman being held at third is a good throw in from the right fielder.
And I said it before, Josh, not the best offensive year, but he has contact to all fields and a very good sharp-hitted single. And now there's men at first and third with only one out. And that'll bring up the top of the lineup.
Send it back to Arlo Rudy. And he is 0 for 1 thus far. Walked his first time up. And one advantage here of having a leadoff hitter up is Arlo is pretty hard to double up as he has good speed on the back end. So ground ball, you got to really turn quick in order to get two. So definitely an RBI situation here for Rudy. So we'll see what he can do. First pitch is way outside. Neither runner will advance.
Came off that backstop pretty good, so came right back to the catcher Flores, so no advance.
So 1-0 pitch. Oh, nope, we're going to have a first to third move that goes to no avail.
And you don't see that very often because this year was the first year they outlawed that in the big leagues. It's now considered a balk. Hostile don't apply. I still all PC.
And now a straight pick off to first. Josh back in.
So this is the interesting situation for the situation, for lack of a better term. You got the runner on first. If he goes to second, you're setting up with your catcher here. Okay, do we cut it off halfway and we don't allow the runner to go home? Do we straight throw to second? Do we try to pick him off? Or, you know, do you just hold on to it and you just see if the third base runner is busting down the line? Then take your chances.
The pitch is swung on and missed.
Arlo extremely out in front, opened up those hits way too early, and that back foot came way off its plan.
And you do have to wonder, El Cerrito does seem to think something's going on, but Josh Cohen, not the greatest speed in the world, so you have to admit that it's probably not going to be a straight steal, if anything, probably a hit and run.
He's got a pretty good lead. He's got one foot on that green turf.
Ball's in the dirt, and a 2-1 count here on Rudy.
So this is the conventional hit-and-run count. Peter dancing off a third.
That ball is hit, foul, over the net, into the neighbor's yard. So I'm sure we'll get an email about that.
Yeah, we'll get an email. 2-2. And if you notice, Josh was running on that pitch. That definitely was the hit-and-run.
So we have a 2-2 count here on Arlo. Delaney comes set. And another pickoff throw. Josh back easily.
So Delaney has single-handedly become the human rain delay. This game is absolutely slowed down.
Yeah, he's not exactly in a rhythm, and I think these pickoff throws aren't exactly helping as that ball is hit sharply on the ground through the old 5.5 hole of the third baseman. And another run will be on the board as Arlo gets the RBI single.
Well, not exactly the greatest game for Rutledge. Two errors and now two strikeouts. And that one just came up on him. And a little bit of an ole there. And as much as I'd like to give Arlo the RBI single, I do believe Rutledge deserves an error. So Scheinman will come in, but that was a sure double play ball.
And Nico Aldaco now steps in as the first pitch is wide for ball one. So we have a first and second here for the Panthers as they narrow up 2-0, bottom four.
It's another gift run as well. It's four errors now for EC. And that is not conducive for trying to win a semifinal.
Still only one down in the inning. Time is called.
But this is the first inning that the Panthers have actually hit Delaney. They've got two singles and that sacrifice and that E5, and now they're in business once again.
Try to throw behind Josh. And you got to imagine there comes a point where the numerous pickoff throws become a little bit unnecessary. The Panthers haven't really been running at all in this game.
And you don't know what kind of arm Flores has, so you would have wanted him to, you know, tested him early, but they're in RBI spots, so they don't want to do anything too fancy here. He does have a 2-0 count.
That ball is hit through the hole once again from Nico, and Josh is held at third as the left fielder got to that quickly. So this is a situation you want if you're the Panthers. Base is loaded for Devin Mahoney.
There's nobody else you want up there right now for the Panthers.
Four home runs, 21 RBIs. Looking for more.
The lefty against the righty. You got the bases loaded with only one out. So we're waiting for something big.
Ball's foul off the fence. Caught over there in foul ground by Josh Cohen off the fence there with the ricochet.
Good hands. So each base runner has their respective lead. Pretty good. See Arlo there at the bottom of your screen. He's got one foot on that green patch.
Pitch on its way is outside, maybe a little bit high too. So 1-1 count here to Devin. This is a big pitch here if you're Delaney. You don't want to go down 2-1.
Because then you have to go in.
The pitch on its way. There's a line shot. Fair ball down the line. One run is in. Two runs are in. Nico is held, and Devin is pumped with the two-run double to break this game open. It is now 4-0 Panthers.
That is a big hit. You double your lead right there. Two runners come in, and now you've got runners at second and third, only one out. You got Kevin Flemmer. This is not going the way Delaney would have liked it to.
And, you know, he'd allow a lot of base runners in the early going, but managed to pitch around it. But you can only do that for so long with this Panthers lineup.
It's the second double for Devin today.
And now Kevin Flemmer steps in looking to add on to the lead.
First two RBIs for the Panthers. And looks like they'll just intentionally walk Flemmer. I guess this is the same strategy they had last time. They're not even going to pitch to Flemmer. They'd rather load the bases and have Max come up, which is a strategy, maybe not the best strategy, as Max has power.
Yeah. Definitely see if this pays out. It does set up the force and the double play opportunity. But at the same time, it does once again load the bases for Max Goldstein.
And that's what they're going for. None of these four hitters or base runners have any kind of Jose Reyes speed, so they're betting on the double play.
And that ball is hit right back up the middle, so the decision comes back to haunt them as Max Goldstein comes through with the RBI single up the middle. The bases are still loaded, and it is now 5-0 Panthers.
Little station-to-station ball. Gotta love that run right there. That one was right at the middle. This is the shortstop wing. Got a pretty good, actually got a glove on it, but nothing he could do as it just went into center field. And now here's Nick Ulch.
Looks like that will be all for Delaney in this game as He was managing to skirt by for a little while, but everything just kind of came crashing down in this fourth inning. The Panthers have exploded for four runs here, so that will be it for Delaney. In the pitch, we have, looks like, number 11.
That would be Cole Flores.
So we'll take a quick break as Flores takes his warm-up pitches, and we will be right back.
So pitching change, as we will have Cole Flores throwing to Flores. That's the battery of Flores and Flores. Nick Ulch is up now with the bases loaded. Andre Sims had to step out, so I'll be taking you to the rest of this inning. This one is popped foul. That'll be the first strike. So Nick not waiting around. Gets the first pitch from the reliever Flores. So Delaney today not sharp. This might be his last game as a senior, and he allowed five runs on unfortunate errors, four errors altogether for the Gauchos. The 0-1 becomes 1-1 as that pitch is inside. So four errors, two on the second baseman Harrison, and another deuce on the third baseman Rutledge. So there's Nick Ulch. Panthers looking to add on more as that one is also inside, 2-1. Peter on deck. He started this inning off with a single. Good hitters count for Nick. Here's the 2-1 from Flores. That one's hit to left field, right at the left fielder. Devin will tag. He will come home. It's a good throw. Devin is there. He is out at home plate. A wonderful throw from the left fielder, Pickett. It'll be a double play when it's all said and done. So an assist going to Pickett. It's a 7-2 double play. And we will move on to the top of the fifth, but a big inning for the Panthers as they get 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 hits, make it 6 altogether as they score 4 more runs. And we will go on, and it'll be 5-0 Panthers. Top of the fifth, 5-0 Panthers. That was Jimmy Smale you saw on your screen, the Panthers center fielder today, giving the Panthers a big shout-out. And they should. They're up 5-0. And should this stay a 5-0 lead, as it most likely will because we got Kevin Fleming on the mound, we will be playing Friday, a game which we will have available to you either here or should Pinole Valley win their game at Pinole Valley. But Flemmer starts Bernal off 1-0. And now 1-1. Bernal K'd his first time in the second inning. 1-1 to Bernal. 1-2 to Bernal. Flemmer's got 7 strikeouts so far. Looking for his 8th right here. And that's off the glove of Steven. Run things 2-2. Looking for the big shutdown inning. That swung on and missed. Went right at him. 3 swings on 3 fastballs, and Bernal is sent back to the pine. 8th strikeout for Flemmer. Now bring up Lucas Lochner Bravo, the 7th place hitter. The right fielder today. First pitch is a strike. My first game, sophomore year of baseball on JV, I hit a 2-run single off of Lucas Lochner Bravo. First at bat in professional high school sports, but that's just a little personal aside. That pitch, right on the money. And that one's a little high. Here's the pitch to Lucas. That is strike 3 called on the outside corner. And make it an even 9 for Flemmer. And it's funny because 9 is not an even number. So a little little talking with the coach now is the umpire heard something from the EC dugout, which he didn't appreciate too much. So just going to talk things over with the coach here. I believe that's what we're talking about. So there's some discussion here. It looks like they're going behind the backstop toward the fan section. So maybe something a fan yelled out, which was not taken . So it'll be Nick Shabek. Grounded out his first time. Down in a crouch, he swings over the first pitch. That curveball stays inside. So it'll become 1-1. And Flemmer, 3 times today, has set down this lineup in order as Shabek swings through that one. He's got another chance to do it right here. 9 strikeouts today. Shabek at the plate. Swings the wood twice. The 1-2 from Flemmer on its way. Strike three called. 10 strikeouts for Kevin Flemmer. We will go to the bottom of the fifth. Flemmer walks off the mound very happy. And so am I. Bottom of the fifth, 5-0 Panthers.
And welcome back. Bottom five here. Peter Simon leading off, and first pitch is a called strike. So the Panthers with a big fourth inning, getting four runs on the board, really just blowing this game wide open. Second pitch is a called strike.
And this was the man who was up to begin that inning. Peter singled, Steven. A little sack bun over him. Then Josh singled. Rudy got on with the E5. Single by Nico. Double by Devin. Walk for Flemmer. Single by Goldstein. And we had a pretty good inning.
Yes, we did. That breaking ball was high on the last pitch.
So it's like Flores to talk things over here. Flores talks to Flores, and now they'll disperse back to their respective positions.
I wonder if they're related.
I don't know. Cole Flores, junior. Chandler Flores, the senior. Possibly. No.
The pitch on its way from Flores to Flores. Swung on and hit into center field. That is caught by the center fielder. That is
Harry Van Eckert.
There you go.
So just kind of hung up there for him.
See, that's how you know we're a team. We finish each other's sentences, ladies and gentlemen.
That's a good one right there. Mr. Andre will be taking over when I leave to go to college next year.
And that will bring up Steven Giantini, sack bunt last time around. First pitch from Flores on its way. That was a breaking ball in there for a strike.
That was a Barry Zito-esque breaking ball. That one started above my head, and it went all the way down to Steven's knees.
Second pitch is a hit high and deep. Just left center field and be caught at what would be the warning track if we had one here. So, got a lot of it, but not quite enough to get it out.
Van Eckert with some good range there. He came all over from the more of a right center position and made the catch.
So, do down quickly here for the Panthers.
No warning track, all turf, football, soccer, baseball field, all one. Multi-purpose venue here at Thomas M. Brady Park.
And a beautiful venue at that.
Established 2009. Josh Cohen is up now.
cone with a opposite field single last time around. Takes the ball in the dirt. 1-1 here. I think it might be 2-0. I'm not quite sure.
We'll go with 1-1.
Was in the dirt, so 2-1.
Well, if he throws it on their ball, we'll soon figure out if it's 2-1 or 3-1.
Pitch on its way. Oh, that's a strike. So 2-2. 3-2. Not quite sure.
We'll go 2-2.
Pitch on his way, and it is swung on and grounded to third. Bobbled a little bit, throw over in the dirt, cannot be picked up by the first baseman, and that will be scored. I think it's a single. Just can't really give an error for not being able to scoop a ball.
Well, if we were going to give an error, I believe that would be on Rutledge. Now, it'd be very cold-hearted because I've already given Rutledge two errors, but when you get a nice two-hopper like that, and you throw it in the dirt. I'm sorry, buddy. I'm cruel, but that's a 35 for you today. Make it 5 Gaucho errors.
Josh scampers back to the bag. So top of the order here. For the Panthers, Arlo Rudy steps in. Still only 0-1. Been on base twice, though, via an error. And a walk. Flores tried to throw his behind Josh. Once again, he scampers back. First pitch on its way. Excuse me. Not first pitch, but pitch on its way. In the dirt.
I believe that was the first pitch, Andre.
No, I don't think it was, because they threw behind him, so.
Ah, very good. 2-0 then.
But, you gotta wonder, Josh must not have been on his toes there, because that ball got away from the catcher.
And with two outs, you hate to make the third out. Well, they always say first or third out at third is a no-no, but you hate to make the third out on any kind of base-running mistake.
Yeah, you hate to bring yourself out of an inning.
Yeah.
So if you're not sure of it, it's better to just stay home. Pitch on its way from Flores, and it is called strike on the outside. Pitchers have been getting that pitch pretty much all day.
It is a generous call.
A little bit of a wide strike zone, but, I mean, it's still consistent, and that's all you can really ask for from an umpire.
Yeah, to each his own. It's a very ambiguous thing, the strike zone, and you're gonna have umpires who call, you know, at the letters, but not the knees, or you'll get knees, not the letters. You might not get any. You might get the inside corner. It all depends on the umpire you get.
Pitch on its way, and it is high. Once again, throwing behind.
And I think we're starting to get up a little bit of a obsession here, because Josh Cohen, as you said, not the greatest base runner, but I think he's been on twice, and I think they maybe try to pick him off maybe 10 times now.
Pitch on its way and upstairs, and that is a walk for Arlo, so tries his second walk of the game.
So with two outs, Nika will now be up, and think back to the error on Rutledge, the one in this inning. That would have ended it, but now an RBI spot for the Panthers' second place hitter. He's singled. 1-for-3 on the day.
First pitch is outside. 4 balls. We have first and second here. 2 down for the Panthers. Nico Aldaco, the sophomore, in the box. Ahead 1-0. There's that outside strike again. So 1-1 here.
And the Gauchos are down by 5, which is big, but not insurmountable. So definitely do not want to give away another run here, especially with 2 outs.
Breaking balls upstairs. But and you say it might not be insurmountable, but with the way Ken Plummer's been dealing.
It's Yeah.
It might be insurmountable.
It's possible, but not plausible. You want to be optimistic, but you have to be realistic.
Very true. So the 2-1 pitch to Aldaco is on its way. It is a little bit low.
Thought he might have given him that one there. It was pretty good. Not the best frame job by that catcher, but it was a pretty good location.
But you got to think that with the lack of command that the outfield pitchers have shown so far, you're not going to get those close calls the way that Flemmer would.
Not at all.
Being around the plate.
You got to earn your respect from the umpire.
Pitch inside and back-to-back walks here for Flores. And once again, the bases are loaded for
Devin Mahoney.
There you go.
This is all because of that error on Rutledge, his third of this game.
And got to feel bad for Rutledge, because if Devin were to get a hold of one here, he would really just be kicking himself.
So get excited, folks. This will be interesting.
First pitch from Flores is upstairs. Ball one.
Wrong.
Flores comes set. A pitch to Devin. With a little bit of like a two-seam cut fastball action there. And got the call strike on the inside half.
Sink back to that inside corner. Pretty good pitch. 1-0.
So an even count here. 1-1. That was a foul ball down the line. Josh Cohen had to hop out of the way of that one as it came right for his ankles.
Now, hypothetically speaking, if that hit Josh, now if he was standing in fair territory, he would have been out. And if he was standing in foul territory, it would have been a foul ball. Just a little tidbit for you. Food for thought.
So 1-2 here, but by no means is Devin down in the count. Way outside, and it goes even to 2-2. It's a very tough situation here for Flores, as you want to come up with a strike, but you can't just lay one out there, because this game could easily become 9-0 as opposed to 5-0.
The Panthers have had 16 base runners on 6 hits.
That's a lot of errors and a lot of walks.
It's not a good formula for a win.
Arlo, in his own right, has been on base 3 times without a hit in this game.
Devin's had 2 doubles.
Pitches inside. The count runs full.
So payoff pitch. 3-2. 2 outs. Bottom of the 5th. Bases are juiced. Ducks on the pond.
Pitch on its way.
And it's a good call there, because you're running on the pitch. So it's a pretty good job to check on the runner at third to try to catch him napping.
Pitch on his way, and it is fouled back to the screen, and we'll set it up and do it again. And the way the outfielders are positioned here, there's a center field, left field. There is not much room to hit it over their head. It's either gone or it's going to get caught.
The center fielder, Van Eckert, is probably 5 yards away from the fence. Then he'll step off again.
It's more of those pickoff moves. I understand trying to catch people off guard, but once is enough.
A little excessive.
Yeah. And that pitch is high and outside, and we ball 4, walks in a run, 6-0 Panthers.
An RBI for Devin.
And, Tyler, this time they can't potentially walk Kevin because there's nowhere to put him.
They're going to have to pitch to him here. Flemmer flew out his first time and then was walked twice. Cohen will come in and score, so he scores on the E5. He scored 2 runs today.
First pitch is in the dirt. That's pointed out by our camerawoman, Sylvia. And the count goes to 1-0. And Tyler, as I look around this field, you start to see the the body language of El Cerrito. They're starting to look really defeated out there.
Now, they're out there for a long time. You get an error, get a couple walks, not a lot of action. There hasn't been a ball hit in play this entire inning. It was two fly balls to the center fielder. But now he's gone 3-0 on Flemmer. You've had three straight walks. It's just...
The outfielders are pacing. They're taking their hats off. And their heads are down. It's just not the body language of a team that wants to come back and be resilient in this game.
That one's in there. I mean, you can't blame them. It's very difficult to keep awareness out there in a very less than exciting inning.
Well, it's fouled off the screen by Flemmer, and the count goes to 3-2. So once again, we'll have a full count here. Base is still loaded. Two down. Panthers already went with the run in this inning. Pitch on its way from Flores. And it is roped to left field. That is a fair ball all the way to the fence. Two runs are in. Devin coming around to score. And it would be a ground rule double, as I think he went underneath the fence.
I do not believe they'll send Devin back. Or they will.
I think they are sending Devin back.
So a big time two-run double. The Panthers are going to get two more. And Andre, if the Panthers score his next two runs, they win.
Yeah. Yeah, they do. So the umpires have a little chat here. I'm not sure whether they're going deciding whether or not to let Devin score or not. Because Devin was on his horse.
He was busting his way around third.
I really think he was around third before time was even called by the left fielder. Now, whether that was a matter of left fielder waiting a little while and being a little nonchalant and him calling time, or in fact, Devin was just outran the baseball.
Nonetheless, he will stay at third base. So Devin on third, Kevin on second, and here's Max.
Max Goldstein was an RBI single last time up as they walked Flemmer to get to him, and he came through. So he steps in here. Panthers already up 8-0. First pitch is low.
The Panthers, in two games, only scored a combined 6 runs against El Cerrito, and they put up 8 here.
Tyler, like you said, if these two runs score,
it'll be a walk-off, technically.
Yes, it will. And both runners in scoring position right now in a 2-0 count. Max Goldstein is in the driver's seat.
So Max can send us home early, which I appreciate. Got to get started on my homework. So a 3-0 count to Max Goldstein.
That was a called strike in the 3-0. Another called strike on the outside corner. So the count runs full here. Still two down in this inning. Panthers have just been coming up with the clutch 2-out RBI hits.
This is all because of the error at third.
They fouled it. Catcher unable to hold on. So Max lives to see another pitch. Full count here. Max steps back in the box. That will be caught on the leaping catch by the second baseman. Nice play. Almost potentially the game-winning hit there, but snagged at second. And we will head to the top of the sixth. I will send the play-by-play mic back over to Tyler Petersen. It's been fun giving you these three innings, and we'll be right back. Panthers up 8-0.
Flemmer back on the mound. Panthers scored another three runs that inning, only on one hit. That was the Flemmer double that brought in a pair.
And you got to imagine Flemmer's pretty comfortable out there pitching with an eight-run lead.
Well, he's given up only two hits. He's pitched only two over the minimum. Here's Harrison. He will lead things off top of six. Hits this one high on the infield. Nico Aldaco calling off the third baseman. He'll make the catch. So fly out to six, the shortstop. Bring the leadoff hitter, Pickett. First pitch to Flemmer. It's
do we have access to that?
That one is line foul. SPSV is playing Pinole Valley right now. Should SPSV win that game, the Panthers would host here at St. Mary's. Pinole Valley would have the tiebreaker against St. Mary's as Pickett fouls that one away as well, meaning the Panthers would have to go to Pinole Valley on Friday and play the Spartans in their house for the TCAL final. They're looking pretty good today, though. Ground ball to Ulch. He'll take that himself, and there are two outs. So here's Brad Wing, or Alexander Wing, take that. I don't know where I got Brad from. Alex Wing up there, second place hitter, the shortstop today. He's singled one for two today. That one's outside. Flemmer's set. Now starts his windup. Throws. That's popped up. Out goes Nico. He'll make the catch. And this inning is over. Another 1-2-3 for Flemmer. We will go to the bottom of the sixth. 8-0, Panthers. New pitcher for the Gauchos as Lucas Lochner Bravo comes in. First pitch to Nick Ulch. It's a little bit high. 1-0 the count. This one is popped up right behind second base. Shortstop wing. Catch that. First pitch to Alarudi, or make that Peter Scheinman. There's a strike.
Confusing the high socks for the stirrups there.
That's correct. Second pitch is in the dirt, gets way away from Flores. It'll be 1-1. Here's the 1-1. That's grounded towards first. The first baseman's got it. Foot race to the bag of Peter. And that'll be second out. So that'll bring up Steven Giantini. First pitch, strike. Giantini today, 0-2, struck out, flew out to center, had a sacrifice. That one is also a strike. So two strikes to Steven Giantini with two outs. One, we're about ready to pitch this top of the seventh, and here's the 0-2. That is on the corner, strike three called. We will go to the top of the seventh. Panthers three outs away from going to the final on Saturday. 8-0. top seven. Flemmer back on the hill. We will see 3, 4, 5 hitters.
Hey, y'all, what's that smell?
Jimmy Smales fired up in the middle of your screen. And so is Kevin Flemmer. He goes to work. Parry Van Eckert, 0-for-1, struck out and walked. First pitch of the third place hitter is outside.
And Tyler, Flemmer has really just had it on cruise control this entire game. Only 2 hits allowed.
Only 11, 1 walk.
11 strikeouts, if my count's correct.
That one hits a deep right field. Devin going back, and that's in a triple's alley. And that is over the fence for a ground rule double. So Parry Van Eckert gets a hold of one and hits one to the deepest part of the yard. Anywhere else, it's a home run, but there it's only a double.
Gotta love that right field corner. And I say corner because it's actually a corner.
It's very synonymous with the AT&T Park, the dimensions here we have, except we don't have a big old wall out in right field.
Nor do we have a cove to hit home runs into.
And I would like a Coke bottle, but, you know, something's administration. We can't really have a slide out here. So
yeah, I'm not sure if the neighbors would allow that.
Here's Rutledge. This one's hit the center. Jimmy going in. He's got that. Parry will not tag. And Jimmy with the catch. His second out today. So one out.
Jimmy Smale definitely a fan favorite among the fans out here.
Patrolling center today. There he is, number 26, but on the left screen. Here's Delaney. Or not Delaney, it's Cole Flores who came in for him. Flores fouls away the first pitch. Parry on second. The 0-1 from Flemmer. Here it is. And that one is hit to shallow right field. That'll get onto the track, bounce once, and
not over the fence, though.
Settle
so
over there by the
one less email for the administrators.
Hurdles. Yes, one less email. So it's 0-2. Flemmer's got 10 strikeouts. Swing and a miss. 11 Ks for Flemmer. And now he's one out away from taking this team to the finals. League finals. Here's Bernal. First pitch is high. Bernal has struck out twice. Where's number 23 on his back? Steps in now, taps the plate a couple times. We're all set as Kevin puts the ball in the glove. It's his hit. Shallow left, shallow right. Nick catches, and we will see you Friday afternoon.
Beautiful. Great game pitched by Kevin Flemmer. Complete game. Shutout. 3 hits allowed. 11 strikeouts. And like Tyler said, we will see you on Friday. Now, the only question that remains is
who will whether we play?
We'll see you here from Brady Park or we'll be coming to you live from Pinole Valley as Pinole Valley and SVSV are playing right now. And unfortunately, we do not know the score of that game. And so We will see you on Friday, and hope you had fun. For everyone here at a Panther Broadcast Network, from Andre Sims, Tyler Petersen, Sylvia on camera. And it's been fun bringing this to you. Final score, 8-0 Panthers. And thanks for watching, everyone. And goodbye.